Well, I wasn't, you know, no, I wasn't brought up girl fashion. I was outdoors all the time. When they did the hay, and somebody had to drive the team to lift the hay off of the wagon and get it in at the barn, I had to go and drive the team down till the fork had gotten in over the hayloft, and then they dropped it. And then they'd come back, and I'd bring the horses back, and then I'd drive down just so they'd holler at me to when to stop. And I'd help put more hay in those barns and every time they were short of somebody to do that. All it needed was somebody to drive a pair of horses and then pick up the, whatchamacallit, I've forgotten what they call it, and drive them back there and hook on to the fork and take it into the barn and go sliding on the slide. And I never really was a girl as a child. I was with, when Howard was first, went to school, he was turned over to me to keep track of him and see that nothing happened to Howard. And so Howard and I played together all our lives. And I don't know why we didn't carry on afterward. Isn't it funny?
Yeah, it is strange.
But we didn't.
But you didn't correspond?
No. Oh, I write to him occasionally, but it wasn't the way it should have been. Although Howard came up to see me up in Dublin, and two or three times. We were together all the time. And I rescued him twice in his life.
Tell about that.
Well, one day Father sent us up, sent Howard up with a calf. To put in the pasture up on the hill, and where they kept the horses and cows and things. And Howard got up there. He went alone for once. I don't know. I had something I had to do. I don't know what it was. But anyway, he went up there, and by and by, he didn't show up. Oh, I got too close?
No.
I waited, he didn't come back. And down like that. Is that it?
Just so it
rests. Yes.
Yeah.
And so I started up to find him. Well, I found him halfway up. I found him lying on the ground, and he couldn't untie the knot that Father had tied on the rope that was on the calf. So he had his little knife, and he cut it. And when he cut it, he jabbed himself there. Cut that vein open, and here he was, blood from here down dripping off his hand, you know. And I didn't know enough to pick him up and carry him. I guess I wasn't big enough. But I did get him home. And I was too young to know anything about tying something around his arm. But I got him home safely. And they had to call a doctor and get him fixed up.
Did you have to carry him?
Yeah, I carried him part of the way. And
how many years younger was he?
Year and a half.
A year and a half.
Yeah. And
how old were you at this time?
Oh, let me see if I can remember. Well, we were old enough so that we took horses up to the pasture. I must have been 12, 11 or 12, I imagine. And
what was the other time?
The other time was we went down to the long pond down below the house. It was a flat place that when it froze up in the winter, it wouldn't break up, but the water would come gushing down and under the ice and break it up down below. And we stopped to watch that water run under. Oh, it was just bubbling and going down under the ice, you know. And we were on the slippery grass. There wasn't any snow. It was wet, but we were standing there on the bank. And all of a sudden, Howard went in, fell in. And I had presence of mind enough to get a hold of him, but I had to pull like everything to pull him back out from going under the ice, you know. And I got him out and took him up. We were on the wrong side of the creek from the house, so we had to go up boiler house, one of the boiler houses. It was on that side of the brook. And then there was a steam box up over the brook, and the water was gushing under there, you know. And I got him. He said he couldn't go across. He was afraid, and I got him to go sit down, and he was soaking wet, you know, and it was cold winter day, and so I got him down on his hands and knees, and I got down on with his legs a straddle, and then made him hitch himself along, but I held on to him. I went ahead. And I got him over there, got him up to the house, soaking wet, and all he had was a bad cold.
Well, wasn't he lucky?
Yes, he was. I don't know. We had lots of experiences, Howard and I. And he was a very timid little boy. Sort of, you know, and we did all sorts of things. We climbed oil derricks, and we had a grand time together, but he was a little bit timid about things. Wasn't daring. He didn't, I was the one.
But he'd do what you did.
What?
He would do what you did, didn't he? If you did.
Yes, whatever I did,
yeah,
he did.
He would do it.
Yeah, and I suppose I got him into lots of things. But he was.
What finally happened to Howard?
He married Blanche. And Blanche. What was Blanche's name? I rode to school with her father. Wheeler, no, it wasn't Wheeler. It was something like Cutter or something like. No, that isn't right. Isn't it funny? I don't remember.
But it was somebody you knew.
Yes.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. And she was a very bossy woman. Tom used to feel so sorry for Howard.
Now, who was Tom?
My older brother, oldest brother. Yeah. He thought, he said, she killed him, feeding him nothing but boiled potatoes and something. I don't know what it was. What was it?
But didn't Uncle Tom die before Uncle
Tom? Yes, he did. Uncle Tom died of brain tumor. Mm-hmm. But that kid, Tom, honestly, if he bumped his head once, he did 100 times. He was into everything. He was a regular daredevil.
Tom was the oldest
boy. And he was a little naughty little boy.
Now, what were the names of all of your brothers and sisters?
Tom was born in 79.
Do you remember their middle name?
What?
Do you remember their middle name, too? Tom?
Thomas Tate.
Tate
Fox.
Tom, yeah. And
1879.
Yes. And it was just as they were discovering oil there in Bradford, and she was living in a little shack at the time.
Who was?
The mother and father. And
that lovely woman.
Yeah. She was in this little one-room shack.
And I didn't know that.
Oh yeah, and the men that went to work, they'd work night and day, you know. And the men were going past that corner of her shack in a line practically all night.